Euclidean ring or Euclidean domain. A commutative ring R without zero devices is said to be Euclidean ring if to every non-zero element A belongs to S, we can assign a non-negative integer D of A such that the first condition is for all A comma B belong to R, both non-zero, D of A comma B is greater than or equals to D of A. The second condition is for any A comma B belong to R and B is non-zero, there exist two more elements Q and R in capital R such that A is equals to BQ plus R, where either R is equal to 0 or D of R is less than D of B. Note, D of A is called D value of A. For any A is non-zero element in R, D of A must be always greater than or equals to 0. Point number 2 in the definition is known as division algorithm. We don't assign any value to D of 0, which means D of A remains undefined when A is equals to 0. We will prove a theorem. The ring of integers, namely z, comma, addition and multiplication, is an Euclidean ring. Proof: we know that the ring of integers z, comma, plus, comma, dot is a commutative ring without zero divisors. Let the D function on the non-zero element of z be defined as D of A is equals to modulus of A. For all A not equal to 0 belong to Z. Let A not equal to 0 belong to Z and B not equal to 0 belong to Z. Then D of A comma B is equals to modulus of A into B by the definition of D function. We know that modulus of A into B is always equals to mod A into mod B. Therefore, that is equals to modulus of A into modulus of B. Since B is not equal to 0, modulus of B is greater than or equals to 1. Therefore, modulus of A into B becomes mod A, but modulus of B is greater than or equal to 1, therefore which is greater than or equals to modulus of A into 1. Modulus of A is nothing but D of A, therefore that is equal to D of A. Thus D of A into B is greater than or equals to D of A, let us call it as 1. Thus, the first condition of Euclidean ring is satisfied. Let us prove the second condition, namely division algorithm. Let A belong to Z, B is not equal to 0, belong to Z, then there exist two more integers Q and R such that A is equal to B into Q plus R, where 0 less than or equals to R less than modulus of B. This is known as division algorithm. Thus, A equal to BQ plus R, where R is equal to 0, or modulus of R is less than modulus of B. That is, modulus of R is nothing but D of R, modulus of B is D of B. That is, D of R is less than D of B. This is number 2. And this is the second condition of Euclidean ring. Thus, from 1 and 2, it is clear that z, comma, plus, comma, dot is an Euclidean ring. we shall now prove that every Euclidean ring is a principal ideal ring. Proof: let R be an Euclidean ring, let S be an arbitrary ideal of R. Now we have to show that this S is a principal ideal. If S is the null ideal, then S is generated by the zero element 0, that is the ideal of R generated by 0. In this case, S is a principal ideal. Let us suppose that S is not a null ideal. Then there exist elements in S which are non-zero. Let B be a non-zero element in S such that D of B is minimum, which means there exists no element C belongs to S such that D of C is less than D of B. We shall now show that S is generated by small b. So we show that S is equals to the angle bracket B. To show this, first we show that S is a subset of the angle bracket B, and the angle bracket B is a subset of S. First we show that S is a subset of angle bracket B. Angle bracket B is nothing but the generator B. That is, the elements of S is generated by B. Let A belong to S. Then by second part of definition of Euclidean ring, there exist elements Q, R belong to R such that A is equal to BQ plus R, where R equal to 0, R D of R is less than D of B. Let us call it as 1. Now, Q belongs to R, B belongs to S. Since S is an ideal, B into Q belongs to S. Again, A belongs to S, BQ belongs to S. Since S is an ideal and it is a subgroup, therefore A minus BQ belongs to S. What is A minus BQ? A minus BQ is nothing but R. This implies R belongs to S. Thus R belongs to S, and from 1 we have either R equal to 0 or D of R is less than D of B. But we know that D of B is minimum. But here D of R is less than the minimum, which is not possible. Therefore D of R less than D of B is not possible. That is, D of R is not less than D of B. And hence the only possibility is R equals to 0. Therefore, 1 becomes A equals to BQ plus R, but R equal to 0. Therefore, A equal to BQ. That is, A is a multiple of B. That is, A belongs to the angle bracket B. Thus, A belongs to S implies A belongs to angle bracket B. That is, S is a subset of angle bracket B. Now, we have to show that the angle bracket B is a subset of S. Again, suppose that XB belongs to the angle bracket B. Now, X belongs to R, B is from S. Therefore, X into B belongs to S since S is an ideal. That is, X into B belongs to angle bracket B implies X into B belongs to S. That is, every element in the angle bracket B is in capital S. Therefore, angle bracket B is a subset of S. Let us call it as 2. So, from 1 and 2, we see that S is equals to angle bracket B. Therefore, S is a principal ideal. Since S is an arbitrary ideal, every ideal in R is a principal ideal. Hence, R is a principal ideal. Note, every Euclidean ring possesses unity element. Every field is an Euclidean ring.